Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making an Ale-8-One cake. Some of you may have come along with us on our field trip when we went to the Ale-8-One bottling plant in Winchester, Kentucky. And we came back with some Ale-8-One. You can buy it here locally. I doubt that all of you can get it, but you can get it online if you want to go to www.ale, and then there's a dash, 8, and dash, and then the word one.com. Then you'll find they have all sorts of things for sale. They have the drink itself, and then some items like barbecue sauce and salsa that are made from the drink. They have recipes as well, so if you want to buy some of their products, then you can use their recipes. I'm going to make a cake that is sort of traditional in Kentucky. And if you make this cake and cannot get the Ale-8-One, you can use ginger ale. You can use Mountain Dew or Sprite or 7-Up or some drink like that, something that is kind of lemony or kind of gingery. But it just needs to be a carbonated beverage. It's not an alcoholic beverage at all. Just because it says ale here does not indicate that it is true ale. All right, let's start with our eggs. What I have are 4 eggs, and I've already beaten them. So I'm through with my mixer. I think everything else will just stir in. The first thing that we stir into our eggs will be a cake mix. And I usually try to make most of my items from scratch, but then some of them really are enhanced by the flavors that you can get from a mix. So in this case, if you can get a lemon cake mix, this will be perfect. If you can't get lemon, then try a butter cake mix. If you can't get that, yellow or white cake mixes are great, but just go ahead and put all that in. I've opened it, and that container is going to be added in. Not the container, hopefully. And we have that. Next comes some pudding, and I'm using the JELL-O brand of pudding, and I've gotten the type that says cook and serve. You can use instant if you like, so it doesn't have the cook and serve label on it. I would probably stay away from the sugar-free varieties because you never know how they're going to turn out in baked goods. It could be that the sweetness just disappears and it becomes bitterness. So you don't want to ruin all of your work and all of your ingredients. So this is about 4.6 ounces, I think. It's near 5 ounces. If you get the cook and serve variety, I don't know what the weight is on the other type, the instant. But the one that takes 3 cups of milk to make the pudding is the size I'm using. So we just add in the pudding mix, but don't make the pudding, don't add the milk or anything. And this is vanilla flavor. If you choose another flavor, it'll be fine. It could be banana or pineapple or lemon. Whatever you choose to put together with your lemon flavor that you have in your cake mix. Then we need some cooking oil. This is just vegetable oil, 3/4 of a cup. That's going in. And this is really a simple thing to do since we're using a mix, 2 mixes actually. Now comes your Ale-8-One. This is a 12-ounce bottle and I need 10 ounces, so I'm just going to pour this. And it's not going to foam up too much, but you can definitely see the color now, and I'm shooting for 10 ounces. This is about 10 ounces, and it leaves a little bit in the bottle for me to drink. But when you look at the color, it really looks like ginger ale, and the basis of the flavor is ginger. So that's probably the best match that you're going to get if you decide to use something else. But feel free to use 7-Up or any of those others that I mentioned. So this goes in. It wants to foam up a little more when you put it over here than it does just pouring it into the measuring cup. Now I'm going to go away and get this all mixed up, and then I'll talk about the dish that I'm going to put it in to bake it in the oven. Here is the Ale-8-One cake batter. Once I have it mixed together and I started mixing with a spoon, and actually my batter is in a bowl that is kind of small for the amount of batter, but I wanted to be able to lift the bowl and pour it in, so I didn't want a bowl that was too big. So just use your own judgment on that. What I did notice was that if I continued to mix it with this large spoon, it would probably have quite a few lumps in it. So I brought the mixer back for about 2 minutes, and I beat it with a mixer and got the lumps out. There might be a few here and there, but that's not too important. And I'm just going to pour it into my prepared dish. This dish has been buttered and floured. So if you'd like to prepare it like that, that's an alternative to spraying. I usually spray my dishes on the bottom and the sides so that the food will come out easily. But I thought this time let's just do it a little differently. And I put butter on the bottom first, all the way around the bottom and the sides, and then I sprinkled flour, and then I shook it until it was even and poured off any excess flour. So here goes the batter in, and it will just spread out. And by the way, this pan should be something like 13 by 9 by 2. Mine actually happens to be 12 by 9 and a half, by a little deeper than 2. That means the area is approximately the same and it's a little deeper, so it will substitute pretty well. The cooking time is going to be probably 40 to 45 minutes, and the heat is going to be 375 degrees. So I've scraped out enough of that, I think, for you to see what it's going to look like. This is going straight into the oven. I'm going to bake it, and I am going to test with a toothpick, and I'll probably start testing after 30 minutes because it could be done. I don't think it will be, but I will put the toothpick in. If it comes out clean in the center, then it will be done. What needs to happen when this comes out of the oven is it needs to cool. So I'll be letting it cool at room temperature, and then if I want to speed it up after that, I can put it in the refrigerator. Now, once we are at that point, I'm going to show it to you, and you're finished. That's your cake. Or you can make an icing that I have that accompanies an Ale-8-One cake, and that will be a different upload. Because some of you may want to use that icing for a different cake, and some of you may not want to use that icing for this cake. So it gives you some options. But I'll see you back with a cake that is done later on. Here's the cake, and it's been baking at 375 for 40 minutes. And you can see it's nice and brown, so it's a good thing that I had my aluminum foil up here to keep it from getting browner. I tested it at 30 minutes. It wasn't quite done. So at 40 minutes, in the deepest part, put a toothpick. If it comes out clean, and I consider that to be clean, then it's ready to take out. So here we go. And this is the finished cake. Now I'm going to let it cool, and I will be making a frosting for mine, but that will be in a separate upload. So if you want to see that, look for Ale-8-One cake frosting or icing, I don't know what I call it. But if you want to serve it like this, let it cool at least a little bit so you can serve it warm, or you can get it all the way cool, even chilled, and serve it. It will eventually be refrigerated.